Khan, we have with us Mr. Shri Rupesh Kohli ji, Executive Director Testing at RDSO, who has given his presentation, who has presented a copy on the dedicated rail test track, a global standard facility being built in India for the world. Welcome, sir. Welcome to InnoMetro 4th edition. How has your experience been so far here at the event?
First of all, thank you. Thank you for having me here. And I would like to thank as well as congratulate everyone who has been involved in the sort of organizing InnoMetro, the 4th edition. It's been an excellent experience. It's been a learning experience for me and an opportunity to interact with so many leaders in the metro field as well as standard gauge rolling stock manufacturers. So it's been a great opportunity. It's been a great experience so far.
Sir, please share some insights on your presentation that you have given today.
So the topic that I tried to cover and tried to utilize the platform of this conference was on the dedicated test track that the Indian Railways are building. We are already building a broad gauge dedicated test track. And the Indian Railways has also proposed that we will also try and build, and if the industry needs it and if the stakeholders actually require it, a standard gauge dedicated test track could also be built along with the broad gauge dedicated test track that is coming up. The Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs and the Ministry of Railways has had detailed dialogues with different stakeholders, and I only chose the platform of this conference because it had large number of stakeholders from the metro organizations and from the standard gauge rolling stock manufacturers to just kind of flag this point, just bring to their notice. They may not be aware directly, or not all of them would be aware of the efforts that are going up in terms of the dedicated test track. So that was essentially what my presentation was about, and that's what I was trying to convey through it.
Sir, what is the significance of that particular development that you're focusing on?
Yeah, so presently the rolling stock certifications or the validations are done on existing network. So for the Indian Railways, they are done on our revenue tracks, and for the metro systems, they are done on their respective metro systems. A dedicated test track would, number one, mean that the validations will go to a dedicated facility, so we will need not come to a revenue track for doing trials. That's one. And second and more importantly, we are also shifting in terms of the methodology that we use for these validations. So we are going to what is globally recognized as EN14363. I'll repeat, EN14363 type of validations. It's a very well established methodology of rolling stock certification and validation. And those tests, EN14363 based tests and trials, will be more efficiently carried out in this dedicated test track facility. So that's the purpose of the facility.
So what is that one significant change or update that's been done for the dedicated tracks, rather based on older versions of the tracks?
Yeah, so per se, there is, as far as the track themselves are concerned, there is no change in the track itself, but it is an entire dedicated facility for the tests and trials of the rolling stocks.
Okay, sir.
So that itself is completely, it's a completely different thing. Indian Railways did not have this, and Indian Railways has been talking about this project for decades now, but it is finally coming through. So the broad gauge dedicated test track is expected to be up and running completely maybe sometime next year, and we are also proposing the standard gauge broad track, which I discussed about.
So my next question is, what is that one problems that you face to implement these new designs?
There is no such problem, ma'am, as such, but the only thing is that a rolling stock introduction as well as validation is a long drawn process, and it also has a huge stake, because the rolling stock investment is a major investment that any railroad company does. And hence the rolling stock certification part becomes that much more critical. More so in a standard gauge perspective, because the standard gauge rolling stock, because most of them have European origins, they are already validated by the manufacturers elsewhere. So those validations, when they are done with a different methodology, if they result into different kind of results, then there could be some issues. But generally, It is a very serious matter in terms of the rolling stock certification, because that's the series of tests after which the rolling stocks are cleared for regular operations. So all our passengers, all our customers will travel in those rolling stocks at the maximum designated speeds, and hence those tests and criticality of those tests cannot be stressed further. So that's important.
So lastly, I would like to ask you your insights and experience at the Metro 4th edition.
Yeah, so like I began by saying, it's been a wonderful experience. It's my first time at InnoMetro. I didn't come to the earlier three editions, but I was lucky to be part of the InnoMetro 4. Large number of stakeholders were here, and it was a wonderful opportunity to learn, to know about different metro systems, the technologies that they are using, and also to put forward my point as far as the dedicated test track. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.